so many experiences that are there, the infinity of experiences. Meditation will move us to become equanimous, to see that everything is an experience. In the quantum field of infinite possibilities, there are so many things can happen. Because we have a notion that this is the way it must happen, because we have a notion something is far superior than the other, some experience is more superior than the other, try to analyze against what we think is superior. Particularly meditation experiences. I like this notion that if you go and analyze, then since my journey is different, your journey is different, everybody's journey is different, and that different path can be in many, many ways. So how can everyone's path is infinite, everyone's path is so different. Well, we cannot in any way analyze and say this is how it's happening. This is the reason it is happening. The reasons can be many for any experience. When I see a lion, now every experience is teaching us something, but that needs to be more intuitive for us. When I see a lion, animals do give messages. Animals do give messages. Increase your self-worth, potential. Do what is required for now. Don't go on accumulating. Many, many symbolically, the animals can give messages, but it needs to become more intuitive for us. Shaman masters live with nature, and so they have so much knowledge. It is ancient knowledge is there with them. It is bound to happen that in meditation, we are going to get many, many experiences. Our dreams are going to become very, very clear with meditation. Our dreams become a lot more clear in meditation. Initially, before meditation, we have a lot more jumbled up dreams. But once you start meditating, you start gaining more and more clearer dreams, because dreams are a great, great, great way of receiving information, messages for what we are intending. The quantum field is responding, observation manifests possibilities. When you are observing an end experience, to lead to that experience, everything that's required can keep coming to us, either in the dream or in a meditation experience, or during daytime in some way or the other through a message, during wakeful state. If it is intuitive, if it is connecting to us, then we take it. If we don't connect and if we don't understand it, then we don't go on analyzing it instead of just writing it down. Accept that an experience can come, and then we move on. Then we go, of course, a step further as we gain greater acceptance from Bhagavad Gita. Whether you get something that you want, if you get something you want, and if you don't get something you don't want, you are happy. If you get something that you do not want, and if you don't get something that you want, you're unhappy. But Bhagavad Gita is saying, be equanimous to them. Shubha shubha parityagi. Na hushyati, na dvesti, na shochati, na kankshati, shubha ashubha parityagi. Be equanimous because we are the one we are creating these experiences. Everything is an experience, but the contrast has to be there. If low is not there, high cannot be measured, cannot be felt. Everything is an experience that is sought from that perspective. But if quantum field is understood perfectly, observation manifests a possibility. So without an observation, something coming into our life is prima facie not possible. And so then if something is observed by us, knowingly, unknowingly, acceptingly, unacceptingly, accidentally, if we've been observed, we've been thinking, we've been regretting, we've been feeling bad about events, where we say many things, how is my life going to be so bad from now on because people, this person is not there anymore. When we say that with a lot of feeling, then at some point we got to create it. And we said it a few times, we said it repeatedly for months after losing somebody, saying that. Then it's got to be created at some point in the future. We forget these two are two different events. We feel life is so tough because we're the one who created in the first place. Meditation, of course, more than meditation, the understanding. Meditation helps us to increase our understanding. If we understood that we are complete by ourselves, we are that whole, every day we become whole in that meditation. The more we understand we are the whole, the less we feel something is lacking. And that's where the acceptance starts from there. The analysis drops and acceptance starts from there. It is not an intellectual understanding. It's got to be experienced. The brain has to be cooled off more and more. And then the way you do that is by having a greater experience of yourself. If you have a small problem, you draw a bigger problem. That's why we say go into service. And you see a bigger problem, smaller one becomes minuscule. That's all it is. And when you see something bigger, small things are gone out of the window. I stopped complaining about my shoe when I saw people walking without feet. So the more we understand, the more we experience, and to increase our understanding. And understanding is wisdom, not intellectual knowledge. But knowledge is precursor, so we have to learn. And then automatically, then we're moving towards understanding through experientially, either by our own experience or by carefully studying somebody else's experiences in detail. With more meditation, we make somebody else's experience as our experience. It becomes intuitive to us. It becomes intuitive that I can live without shoe. If it is there, great, but otherwise I can live without shoe. I can live without the Nike shoe. But the more we increase our understanding, and meditation helps us to increase our understanding significantly. And the more whole you feel every day, the less we complain about not having things, the less we judge about somebody else as imperfect. Now, all of this is coming from not accepting an experience, that's all. And Patriji is saying that accept experience is a lack of acceptance. When we not accept an experience, then we start analyzing, we start judging. But all of this foundation for this, dear friends, is a deeper meditation to experience whole. Today, we'll understand meditation, since it's structurally changing the brain in many ways, it is developing some core qualities to build and to experience life more with people around us. Just by dropping all these thousands of thoughts, unwanted thought, we've seen how our body health is increasing scientifically. Today we'll understand from a psychology perspective, as the structurally brain is changing, so our meditation is leading us towards greater awareness, empathy, inspiration, understanding. So that now we live more happily, and then we can also live with others more happily with these core qualities that we develop naturally with regular practice of meditation. Before that, let's go into our practice once again. This simple breath mindfulness meditation, anybody new there? We are observing our normal, natural breath. Our goal of meditation is to empty the mind. We have thousands of thoughts every day, more so when we are living here in this environment, to experience more, but we also have several events and experiences we keep absorbing. So the thoughts are 1,000. Research shows that majority of them are unwanted, negative. So our goal is to empty the mind with our eyes closed. Our goal is to empty the mind so that we slowly, slowly eliminate everything unwanted and the only thing that's important remains. And then our goal is also to, when you empty the mind, to connect with this quantum energy field. And so with your eyes closed, fingers into fingers, hands in your lap comfortably, cross your feet at ankle, and observe your breath. Anywhere in the nose, take a reference point, middle tip, or anywhere, preferably in the middle of the eyebrows, and observe breath is going in and coming out. Your natural breath. When you observe the breath, mind becomes empty. And then be in that empty state of mind for as long as you can. In case thoughts come, attention back to the breath again. Again, observe the breath. Right, friends? These thoughts keep coming, and then we keep bringing our attention back to the breath. This is our training in meditation. Keeping our eyes closed, observing the breath, and thoughts come, bringing attention back to the breath. And when you are in an empty state, there may be sensations. Do not analyze them. Be a witness to them. So these are the four trainings that we do in meditation by practicing it again and again. Right, friends? Relax yourself. This meditation is called Breath Mindfulness Meditation, Anapanasati. Before we start this, we are doing something called heart elevation to help in going to the deeper states of emptiness. Just follow my guidance actually in that process, for the process. Relax yourself. Sit comfortably, dear friends, with your eyes closed. Relax your body. Dear friends, dear masters, keep your hands on your chest area. With your attention on your sacred heart, can you feel your beautiful heart? Connect with it. Feel the seat of all emotions. Feel the center, which is expanding all life with its love, joy, gratitude, compassion. Recollect an experience from your life where you felt enormous love, joy, gratitude, compassion. And relive that moment and elevate yourself. Relive that moment of love, joy, and feel that energy. And allow yourself to direct that energy to every corner of this planet Earth to heal yourself, to heal the planet. Where your attention goes, there the energy flows. Feel it. And slowly, let's go into breath mindfulness meditation. With your fingers into fingers, hands comfortably rested in your lap. Observe your natural in-breath and the out-breath. Our goal is to empty the mind when we observe our breath. The mind becomes empty. When we observe our breath, the mind becomes empty. As the mind is becoming empty, we experience that greater emptiness, that quantum field of energy
Thank you.
అసలు చూసావు. To merge into your breath and allow yourself to become totally empty of all thought. Become aware of the emptiness inside of you, all around you. emptiness is energy. This is the unlimited field of possibilities. The longer you experience this emptiness, this blackness, that void, the more you receive the more you draw these possibilities into your life. Find yourself distracted in thought, go back to observing your breath, dear friends.
Thank you.
as a yourself, to merge into that emptiness of yourself. Everybody and everything are connected in this field. Longer you stay aware of this energy, this emptiness, the more you experience your wholeness. Friends, let's express gratitude . It is an honor and privilege to be exploring this consciousness at this time of history. Can you express gratitude to all things and everybody? Express gratitude to your parents, your teachers, your mentors, your family, your friends, your relatives, your colleagues, everybody. Your gratitude to this grand nature, the bird, the fish, and the animals. Gratitude to everything you, the technology, the system, the government that support you. Gratitude to yourself and to this intelligent quantum field. All is well. All is well. I can rest. I am safe. All is well. All is well. I can. Recall your experiences from the session. How did you feel? What did you see? What have you experienced? Whenever you're ready, keep your hands on your eyes for 5 seconds and then open your eyes. Okay, friends. Yes, Nalini?
Good morning, sir. Sir, today experience, I was in Himalaya. I was doing meditation there, and it is an amazing experience. And the very nice, sir. And when I was sitting in the Himalaya, some energy is flowing. It is a white color energy. Then after some time, my body has become very light and flowing. I'm enjoying that. It is not like tears, like pain tears. It is like a nice tears is coming. I'm enjoying. Body is very light, very light. And after some time, lot of energy is continuously flowing. And suddenly some connectivity from nabi to heart, and that it's flowing like of energy. And it was amazing, the first time I'm experiencing. Then after this, so I was there long time. Then after come to normal, I can become normal. My when the nabi suddenly connected, I don't know how it is, the connectivity is first day of experiencing that. It was very nice, sir. And I don't know how the gratitude, that a nice experience I was felt, and now I'm become normal. But the way I experienced that, and now I'm talking with you, it's like I'm normal now. And I'm very gratitude, and I'm very grateful to the CEOs. Thank you so much. I first experienced this. Thank you so much. That amazing experience you showed to me. Thank you, Chandu sir. You've taken a lot of time, but I personally, I'm enjoying that, and it's amazing experience. I saw that, yes, it is not like that, this thing, but I enjoyed that. I was there in that. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Yes, madam. These are moments of going home and feeling one. Many things are going to happen. But we have to go in. Like you have done, we have to go in with that complete openness. Keep doing it. It is an experience of wholeness that you are enjoying. You're seeing it, you're feeling it. You can't put words to it. Can't put words to it. Thank you for sharing. It's your meditation. Madam, your meditation, your sincerity, your past experiences that were lighter. So the more lighter, the more we peel off our onion of, you know, various things that are there, and which we do with more understanding, more meditation, the more closure we get to the source to do these experiences. Everybody is absolutely going to experience these one or the other. at some time or the other by some predictable field. It's predictable to the extent, it is predictable to the extent that it depends on what our past experiences have been. In this life, we are a multi-dimensional personality in a multiverse, quantum field, quantum physics model. In that energy, everything is happening simultaneously. There is so much is going on. And so it depends on how much of our past experience that we've got. How much, what is our past? Short of saying the samskara, things that we have done, what is that we're wishing on the past? Based on that, then it is coming here. It's like wanting to do in a typical progression could be doing a basic troubleshooting in a product to then going about fixing things in the product, then going about developing, to going about designing, to going about visualizing. So, you know, there are the different experiences. As we gain more and more experience in that field, we are given something higher and higher and higher. We got to go there. It happens though. We have to be prepared to take this experience. We have to be prepared. We cannot give somebody in the right in the beginning and say, here is, design this complex system and then strategize it and architect it, and it falls apart. That experience cannot be absorbed by that person too soon, too early. And so these things do happen, that based on our past we are. But then with every meditation, with every intention, how do I shorten and accelerate it? By increasing our understanding. We got to drop the layers of our judgments, layers of the complaints, layers of our notion of the world, disbelief, doubt, all of those we have to keep dropping. Many more understand by reading all those books that we provided and then giving more. But that some are naturally drawing from the past. Some are naturally drawing from the past wisdom and experience that you've gained. And so we are here. So thank you, Nalini, for sharing it. And the more you experience these, the more you want to go back into being it. Okay. All right, friends. Meditation, when we have these wholeness experiences, like Nalini ji, it is not possible prima facie for us to be non-cooperating with somebody else. It's not possible for us to see somebody else as different than you and me. They're not different. This experience is so intense. And then when we experience that good feeling every day, is soothing our core layers of our brain. But structurally, a few things are happening. Neuroscience is trying to discover this a little bit. When we have such experiences, and when we regularly meditate, when we regularly practice mindfulness, that there is a change to the brain structure. And as a result, we seem to be getting along well with ourselves and with everybody around. Emotionally getting more balanced, more regulated, developing more intelligence. Physical health is essential to experience life. And so meditation removes stress, so we move into a great physical well-being. And so then that is important. We got a project, we got a business, and then suddenly this recurring physical ailment keeps coming back, and then we got to keep checking out. 3 days I'm not there. We go, drag ourselves so difficult. But meditation, the stress is removed, stressors are gone, 90% illness is gone. They're happy. Emotional regulation, emotional intelligence is so essential to be able to move towards a focus. We develop that focus. Focus is so essential to succeed. Right. So one of them is emotional intelligence. Let's understand this a bit today. 11:15. So we got about 20 minutes. So I thought I'd seen this chart, which I thought is a good example of how there is something called amygdala in our brain, which is the emotion center. It is in the subconscious mind, in the second brain. So these names there is a neocortex, which is the frontal cortex, frontal area of the brain. In the conscious mind, which is the big part of the brain, there is a frontal area, neocortex. And there is something called thalamus, which is again inside the subconscious, and which is constantly filtering and taking inputs from the environment, and then it is sort of knows what to send, not to send. It's filtering based on the body's reactions. And then there is this amygdala, which is the emotion center, which is sort of the root of all emotions. And your fear is there, your joy is there, many things are there right inside amygdala, emotion center. What is brain? Brain is a set of neural networks. And so these parts are also neural networks. Neurons are cells, so simply speaking. They all are connected together. They have certain specific roles and responsibility in different parts of the brain. So the conscious mind, we saw, is the brain that is outside. It's called the whole cortex brain, outer brain. Is the thinking brain is where all our logical analysis and learning and all that is in this whole area, that light bluish area. Whereas the subconscious mind, which is inside, which is the limbic brain, is emotions and long-term memory primarily, right? External input gathering. The third thing, the small orange color, is the unconscious brain or the reptile brain, which is more to do with, you know, dealing with our autonomous functions of the body. So here is a thing, right? You know, his thalamus, you know, is tracking all the external signals from the environment. It's called amygdala hijack. What happens, amygdala hijack means every time amygdala is hijacked, that means it's not in your control. Somebody's taken over. Then amygdala takes over, it goes away. That means your emotions are not in control. That emotions are not in control. To be in control, frontal part of the brain, the cortex has to be in control. The conscious in control from there, then you're in control of everything. But subconsciously, we talked about 90% of experience are subconsciously driven, which is through this, through the long-term memory, where the beliefs that are set in a long-term, all of those are sort of drive. So the thalamus, which is scanning for signals, is taking from ear, hey, someone is shouting. And then the neocortex, the frontal part of the brain, is saying, no, don't worry, because it's trying to interpret, analyze. It's saying it's your wife, just smile. Then eye is seeing it now. It's saying, oh, there is a rolling pin coming. You better be careful. Then neocortex is trying to say, okay, fine, let me try to stay calm right now. Maybe there must be a reason. It may not be coming to me. Then the eye is saying, no, it's coming fast towards you. Right. And so then there is another stronger signal going from the eye. It's sensing danger. And so then thalamus is saying, no, I can't give you more time, because the response time of the neocortex is compared to the amygdala response times are, amygdala acts faster. It's 1/4 of the time of a neocortex. And so I can't give you more time to think and analyze. So I'm going to take charge, and then I've got to respond now. I've got to move the body into a certain state. So the emotional peptides, chemicals have to be released. So if I release a stressful response, fight or flight mode immediately right now. So then body has an extra energy, so it's prepared, so it can run if it wants to, right? It can take its position if it wants to, right? So the thalamus is sort of deciding in many ways and then giving the control to amygdala, not to the neocortex anymore. And so the amygdala is the center of fear and emotions. And so then you behave, and we behave a certain way based on our then past experience for which that situation, how we behaved is what we try to do, our past learnings. The amygdala hijack is there, and then we need a better communication, stronger communication between the conscious brain and subconscious brain. So what's happening in meditation, what they've done and they've looked at research, is that they see, first of all, in meditation, they've seen the gray matter thicken significantly. The gray matter means all the neural networks. They've seen it in multiple research. One of the research, they quote Sarah Lager. She's done in 2005. A very, very landmark study that is considered in terms of, you know, the how the gray matter is becoming thicker, the neurons are more and more. And so there is general neural connections are being developed when you people meditate regularly. What is that? It requires that, you know, you have a more balanced supply of resources. We talked about the stress. When the stressful stuff is gone, then your resources are more balanced into the brain as well. Resource means mostly the blood supply. So enough oxygen, enough nutrients, all of them are going through the supply. And we're talking physically here. This whole thing can be explained completely energetically. So it's important we understand a little bit of science. So we're doing it. So the when the neural networks are being developed across the board, and so the conscious brain, the prefrontal cortex that you see there, neocortex means the whole outside brain, which is the conscious mind, the big part of the brain, all of this. In that, the front portion, which is considered the CEO of the brain, which is considered the driver of our mind, which is, takes control, which sort of directs everybody to come together and act once you set a goal. And so this one is important to take charge. And so what they have observed is that a few things they have observed. Number one, this fear center, amygdala, is shrinking in size. They've observed it, fear center shrinking in size. The hippocampus, which is also part of the subconscious long-term memory, is increasing in size. The fear center, the amygdala, is the emotion center. It's got multiple areas, but specifically the area that is dealing with fear and phobias is shrinking in amygdala. That's one thing. And the hippocampus, long-term memory, is increasing in size. And then what they find is that several connections are being formed across the brain. The neurons are forming. And so they found that there is a better connection between prefrontal cortex and amygdala. Meditators, when they keep observing over a period of time, they find that they have a better connection between these two, the emotional center with prefrontal cortex. So because of the better connection, the many things are happening in the way we deal with situations. And of course, we heard Nalini's experience of experiencing that wholeness, which sort of rewriting brain circuits in many ways. And so regular meditators are responding differently. So the same situation here, amygdala with mindfulness always goes through the prefrontal cortex to take a conscious action. And then without mindfulness, it's going directly into releasing hormones. So you take an unconscious action. Unconscious action is something that is already pre-stored based on your past. Based on your past, you know that the only thing you know is to react, only thing you know is to run away or fight and be aggressive. That's what is happening. A conscious action is where you choose, right? Where you choose. So emotional intelligence can be considered into five areas. Emotional intelligence is into five areas. Self-awareness, self-expression, inspiration, empathy, and engagement. Coming together and engaging. We and every meditator is developing these plenty because of the structural changes in the brain, because of emotional control, the amygdala center, which is primarily there, and because of our ability to install new knowledge into our hippocampus by regularly meditating, where you are dropping unwanted thoughts, so you're making your mind more porous, so you receive more, and you're ready to look at new knowledge more openly. Before meditation, nobody wants to look at it. I know it all, attitude. But here you are receiving, you're opening up to receive something. And in many ways it can be explained. Our brain waves are mostly in the alpha state. Alpha state is a state where a low frequency, you are relaxed and you are ready to take more, and then you want to learn. That's the state we are in. So meditation keeps us into the states. I'm not talking about only during meditation. I'm talking even after meditation, and you are in the wakeful time, a person who is regular is constantly keeping their brain waves in a lower frequency state. That means they are ready to receive. They're not ready to jump at. They're not ready to go on talking. So then there are many of these qualities are developed. Awareness, expression, you inspire, you are more empathetic, and you're engaged. So then you get each one by one. Self-awareness is fundamentally awareing about being aware of our thoughts, feelings, and reactions happening in our mind. What's happening to me right now? When I'm walking into my office, when I see my boss, what's happening to me? Am I recollecting yesterday's discussion, that difficult, tough discussion? When I'm calling, I'm seeing a phone call coming from my relative. Oh, what is it about? And I know last month I had, when I visited, there's a lot of things. So now I'm seeing this call again. So is she going to talk about the same again? She's going to bring it up. Or past memories, and so then associated feelings. Now, what are we doing right now? And then reactions, what reaction am I going to take right now? Everything is being observed with all of this awareness. Awareness is fundamental. And then the more we are becoming one with the whole, the more we drop all our unwanted thought. You know, 3 weeks it takes to remove circuits that we don't fire, neuroscience. When we don't fire certain old behaviors, when we have circuits of old behaviors, old knowledge, when we don't recollect unnecessarily, for example, when you understand that if I keep talking about the loss that I had, and then I feel miserable, and then I'm creating more of it, observation manifests possibility. When we understand that, and then when we stay away from it over a period of time, and then 3 to 4 weeks later, a lot of that memory is gone. It's not surfacing that quickly. And so awareness is building up to us, that observer capability is building up to us at every moment as we meditate more and more. We observe ourselves. It's called metacognition. Humans have this capability to observe themselves from a step above. Metacognition. So we observe ourselves. This awareness is fundamental. And that's why awareness is equal to consciousness. Something that is observing. Our mind, let's say, is observed, or the conscious mind is observed. We got to step back and then aware. Observe ourselves. And so the awareness is to observe ourselves simultaneously as we are in the action, right? And so the moment we know, dear friends, then we are responding to situations, not reacting to situations. So it's self-awareness. You know that thing about two monks crossing the river, the story. Two monks are crossing the river, and then there is a girl who needed help. So one monk, the older monk and younger monk, whoever you want to call them, the older monk carried the girl on his back and then crossed over the stream and then leaves her there. She thanks him, and then both of them continue to walk. The younger monk is like boiling inside. We are monks. We're not supposed to touch. We're not supposed to touch women or carry. I mean, you touch women and talk to them. Now you're doing even more than that. You carried her. The younger monk is saying, the older monk is saying, hey, look, I left her there. You're still carrying her even now after so many hours. Awareness. So awareness is foundation for feeling, giving a response. When somebody is, when you gave a comment in your meetings, in your review meetings, somebody gave you a comment. If you're aware, if you're not aware, then you're immediately hijacked by the amygdala and then going back and saying, this person is trying to expose me. And so this is the kind of situation, look at it. This person is trying to expose me again in front of people. So I need to be more defensive. So let me put up my defensive mechanism, right? Even your document has so many things. Let's come to the core of it. This is how we try to avoid things when somebody gives us a comment. We try to put it back onto them by moving them also into a similar situation of their past. So when you're aware, then you're looking at it and saying, no, this is not the way. I have a different response. Let me see. Maybe they're looking for genuinely giving me they're pointing a genuine issue here. Let me take it. Their intention is not to expose me. Their intention is to genuinely fix the thing. Right? So we become aware, and so we actually have a different response. We choose a different response. How do you choose a different response? Only if we learn what are the other responses possible. One, we draw from our past with meditation. We draw from our past. All past experience where we have behaved differently comes up readily to us. That is that intuitive knowledge comes to us, gets done.
Dear friends, just hold on for a minute. Yeah.
Yes, came back. So I'm going to take 2-3 minutes to explain the other one, and then we continue this next week. But let me just talk about so self-awareness is fundamental for us to be, if we have awareness, then we've got it all, dear friends. Patrice had a concept, meditation, enlightenment, awareness, life test, meal. You do meditation and then you understand more and more, then you lead towards enlightenment and understanding. Enlightenment is to understand situations, jnana. And then you have automatically, the awareness builds so much and the life just is there. That means when you really, really perform beautifully in your life, experience life to the core, to the infinite ways. Knowledge, meditation lead towards awareness significantly. And so then we are responding to situations. That means we are choosing how to act. We're not reacting. That's really the key, right? The second thing that's happening for meditators is self-expression. Self-expression. We're expressing things. We become more courageous. You know that fear center, amygdala, shrinking, are the part of the center of the amygdala, which is the emotion center. Fear aspect is shrinking. There are so many fears. Fear of looking bad. Fear of, you know, people judging me. Fear of losing my job. Fear of, you know, survival. Fear of my health. Fear of getting bulldozed or bullied. Everything is a fear. Everything is a fear. There's so many fears are there. Fear of course, death. But all those fears, as meditation is reducing the fear center, shrinking the fear center, And so then, and then meditation, of course, making this connection to the frontal cortex, which can think a little more rationally, we are able to develop that expression capability. We express well. Self-expression. We don't become arrogant, but we express well. We become more balanced in our, because we are aware of our emotions, we become, number one, more balanced. That particular situation, when somebody commented on your document, instead of reacting, if you acted and if you said more balanced response you gave, okay, Ram, I understand it. Can you tell me a little more detail of how we can work together and then fix it? A different response than saying that you were exactly doing the same last time, so why are you pointing to me now? Happens a lot of times, right? Between wife and husband, all the time you're trying to point each other where you are wrong, as opposed to, okay, I'm trying to receive something here, let me see how I can fix myself. Living in the past, one is pointing, somebody is living in the past. Meditators are developing that mindfulness to be in the present moment. So here, self-expression, we become more balanced in expression. And then fears are gone, so we start becoming more truthful. We stop managing people, we stop managing situations. We become more truthful because we have started living to true to our feelings. Meditation lowers the frequency, lowers the unwanted mind analysis, lowers all the fears, lowers all the ego. And so we start becoming more truthful, our feeling center. Feeling center is telling you something here. Hey, don't try to sweep that issue under the carpet. It is long-term not good for the company, to the project, to the organization. Don't try to suppress issues. Come on, bring it out. And it gives you that courage. So we start opening up. We start going and then talking about things to the people. Otherwise, oh, it's not mine. What's the point? Let me not even go there. I've done my work. Okay, I'm done. Good enough for me. Let them bother about what they're doing. We don't take, we're becoming more truthful. We don't manage situations. We don't manage people. Instead, we are being more integral. We go and then talk to them. We express things. Different self-expression is important. Energetically speaking, our thyroid gland, you know, there is this Patanjali Yoga Sutras, Ahimsa and Satya. In Niyamas, first one, Ahimsa, Satya. Ahimsa, Satya, Ashteya, Aparigraha, Brahmacharya. The five are there. And that Satya. Satya is purity of your thought, speech, and action. Everything has to be one. Integral, Trikarana Suddhi. We move into that state where we want to be more integral, more one with everything that we think same, we speak same. Inside your mind, okay, I don't care. Outside your mind, you know, you say, oh, everything is nice. Instead, you know that there's a problem. But outside, okay, fine. We don't even express it. Duality. So meditation is bridging us and then moving us more close to the satya, purity of expression, being truthful. Just the self-expression, dear friends, relieves a lot of challenges with this hormonal imbalance. Self-expression. Release a lot of hormonal imbalance, thyroid gland issues, many, many things go away in the body. Just we start expressing ourselves. So we understand the rest of the three aspects. In the next session, but self-expression and self-awareness are helping us truly start claiming things that are important for us. With fears, we don't ask many things, and so we don't like what we do, and then we suffer, we drag ourselves from doing things. But with self-expression, we start claiming things. Observation manifests possibility. When you express, that means you're putting your attention on it, so it manifests a possibility. And so you start attracting things into your life. I'm looking to go into this project. I'm looking to gain time at home for myself, for my music practice. We start expressing things. If you don't express, nobody's bothered. Consciousness is also not bothered if we don't express it, but we gain the courage to express. Even in a big joint family, we got to express. We are here for our experience. We are the most important person in the world, VIP. There's one thing I learned. are on that quest. We are the VVIP, not somebody else. And so we claim what is truly ours more balancedly. So thank you, dear friends, for going through. But we can understand this, very, very important, and how we improve relationships significantly. Ramesh?
Thank you, sir, for a wonderful session. Good morning, friends and masters. Please complete a self-assessment form if you have not done it. And please look into WhatsApp groups. And please post if you have any questions or any experience sharing. You can use WhatsApp groups. Thank you all.
Okay. Thank you, friends. So I have a session. I'm in Vizag, so I have some sessions today. Buddhasya members are organizing through the Lions Club, through Rotary Club, I keep going, Rotarians. So we'll meet you all tomorrow at 6 a.m. again. Today is Friday. So tomorrow we have business leader session. So we're going to have leaders come in and talk about their meditation journey, and then inspire us more about how meditation is helping. Thank you. Have a wonderful day. Thank you.